Well, this sucks.
Yeah, I give up.
I'd wish we'd known when we were designing these characters that we'd have to make a whole short film with them. Then we could have agreed on some kind of theme.
Yeah, but now we just have this hodgepodge of designs here. How are we going to put all these guys into one cohesive story?
Wait, I got it. Try this on for size.
So there's these four teenagers, right? One of them is a nerd, one of them is a wuss, and one of them is danger prone, and one has blonde hair. So they're out one night and they decide to go to the spooky haunted castle because they heard there was a ghost there. The wuss is all like, ah, I'm spooked, man. The nerd girl is all like, I have glasses. The klutz is all like, this sure is a spooky place. And the one that has hair is all like, let's split up. I have hair, I guess. So they split up and then the monster shows up and starts chasing them all wacky-like and it's funny. And then they all meet up afterwards once they lose the monster and the nerd girl is like, I found this clue. Also, I have glasses. The blonde one is like, cool, I think I know what's going on here. Let's set a trap. I have an ascot. And everyone's like, okay. So they do that, and then they catch the monster, and they unmask it to reveal, oh my god, it's the old man Elizabethan-era fish woman. And it's revealed that she's been dressing up as a monster this whole time to commit, like, insurance fraud or whatever, because apparently the economy is so in the toilet that this is what it's come to now. Also, I forgot to mention, it's the 60s, they have a talking dog, and this happens to them every Thursday.
I don't know. It kind of feels like it's been done before, you know?
Yeah, what? It's fucking terrible. Get that shit out of my life. No offense.
Well, that wasn't very fucking civil.
Alright, I'm gonna put a pin in yours real quick, Spencer, because I got one even better. I call it my idea. It is a period of civil war. This battle princess here stole the designs for the evil empire's space station, but they're in pursuit. She gives the plans to these ghosty boys, and they escape, but she gets caught by the evil fish queen. The ghosts land on this planet and meet this fuchsia-haired girl and this wacky wizard, and the wacky wizard tells the girl that she's got to come help the princess. So they all go to find a pilot, you know? And that pilot is Tiny Vest Hobbit and Harry Ron Swanson. And the whole gang goes flying and ends up on that space station where the princess is being held captive. And they all go to rescue her, but Fish Bitch kills the wizard, and the fuchsia hair girl gets real sad. But they're not done yet, because they gotta go back with the rebel forces and destroy the space station with the plans from the ghost. And they do that and save the day, and they have two great sequels, some garbage prequels, and then 30 years later, some more critically divisive sequels.
I think it's a little too ambitious. We only have so much time.
Okay, then how about this? So first off, everyone's a giant shape-shifting robot from another planet, right? And they're all fighting a war between the evil fish queen robot side and the heroic princess's side. And it seems like the princess's forces are gonna lose, but then suddenly she shows up and is all like, the queen must be stopped, no matter the cost. And then she fights her way to the queen, and then they fight, and the queen's like, I would have waited an eternity for this. Did I mention that they're all like millions of years old? So then the girl with the hat runs out to save the princess, but then—
Nope!
But like—
Nope!
Well, I'm out of ideas then.
Okay then, it's my turn. How about a gang made up of a fiery spirited kid man, an angry fish lady in a crop top, a little girl who loves to cook and also has no eyes, and a crazy hobbit dude with a sword. They go on adventures and Kid Man wants to catch all of these innocent creatures and be the best that there ever was. Fish Crop Top is only there because Kid Man stole her bike, and little girl's only there because the other two need a wise, mature adult. Hobbit dude has no choice. Then, our favorite useless villains show up. Blue-haired old guy and pink-haired lady. Oh, and don't forget Ghosty Cat. That's right. They want our little friend Hobbit dude because he's special, and they will stop at nothing until they have him. But they always fail. No matter what they do, because the series needs to go on forever without having any real stakes. So, they go blasting off into the sky, only to return the next day, and the day after that, and the day after that one, for hundreds and hundreds of episodes later.
I don't know, sounds kind of repetitive.
We don't seem to be generating a lot of ideas with any staying power.
Oh wait, we missed the obvious solution. We missed the whole reason we got together on this very couch and floor. Putting our minds together to create something we all love, something everyone will enjoy. We forgot that this project was supposed to be about the friendship we forged along the way.
Oh my god, Sophie, you're right! What's your idea?
Okay, so sometimes dads get lonely.
Okay, and?
Well, so Mr. Sad Dad goes to the dad orphanage, you know, to adopt a dad. The orphanage is of course run by a dad. Then, when Sad Dad gets there, he has a huge array of other dads that he can adopt and call his own. What do you guys think? What were we talking about again? I don't remember. I blacked out.
I'm over this. Let's get out of here.
Do you guys want to go for lunch?
Yeah, that might be best. Anyone up for ice cream?
I'm lactose intolerant.
Pizza?
I'm pizza intolerant.
There's some good ramen places that we haven't been to yet.
I'm just gonna go home and gnaw on a rock.